Hi, I'm Richard Patterson, Product Manager for ScopeCorders for Yokogawa Corporation of America. ScopeCorders are a hybrid instrument combining an oscilloscope with a data recorder. The DL350 is our portable ScopeCorder, and it introduced a feature called Memory Recorder Mode that also includes an easy setup mode that makes it easy to create long-term data recordings in just a few steps. When I think of long-term data recordings, one of the first things that comes to mind is temperature. And when I think of temperature, I think of reading thermocouples. The DL350 is compatible with three different modules that are capable of connecting to thermocouples. And today, during this video, I'm going to use this 16-channel thermocouple module that connects to this scanner box that has screw terminals where I can connect the 16 thermocouples. And it connects via this cable that I just plug into the module here. The next thing I need to do is go into easy setup mode and set up the way that I'd like to record. I'm going to choose easy setup, then push start. All of the 16 thermocouple channels are contained within channel 1 in my thermocouple module in slot 1. They're called subchannels. I don't need to record the channels in slot 2, so I will deselect those and then click Next. Here I can set the recording time up to a maximum of 50 days for the DL350. For the sake of this demonstration, I'm going to choose 2 minutes, press Enter, and then click Next. The last thing to set up is the sampling interval. Because thermocouples are very slow changing, I'll choose 50 milliseconds or 20 samples per second sampling rate, and then click Finish. This next screen that appears is the All Channel Setup screen. You'll notice next to channel 1 is a plus. If I push that, it expands out and shows all 16 thermocouple channels that belong to channel 1. To start setting up the thermocouples, I'll click on Coupling, and I'm going to choose TC for thermocouple. And next to that, you'll see Type. The default is K-type, but the module is compatible with 13 different types of thermocouples that it has the calibration and scaling curves stored internally for those thermocouples to translate it into Celsius. If I choose Burnout, this will detect if a thermocouple becomes disconnected due to melting on a very hot part that I'm recording the temperature of. Next, I can set the upper and lower limit. Because we're in a room, I'll choose 45 for the upper limit, and I'll choose 18 for the lower limit in degrees Celsius. RJC stands for Reference Junction Compensation. This compensates for an offset at the connection of the thermocouple to the terminal block. Most of the time, this should be turned on. It's going to be tedious to set all 16 channels one at a time, so there's a feature built into the ScopeCorder called Channel Copy. On the top row of tabs, I click Channel Copy, and first I'll choose my source. Under Channel 1, 16 channel temperature voltage, I choose Channel 1, Subchannel 1 that we just finished setting up. For the destination, channel 1 is on. It's going to copy channel 1, subchannel 1 settings to all 16 channels of channel 1. To do that, I just click Copy Execute and wait a few seconds for it to complete. When it's finished, it goes to the main recorder screen and shows me all the channels are set up to go from 18 Celsius to 45 Celsius. So we've succeeded in setting everything up. Last, all I need to do is hit start, and we're recording. I'm recording directly to the SD card installed in the DL350. There are other options as well, such as USB, and there are multiple options for getting the data onto a laptop or PC. Along the bottom, there are different display groups. There's also one that says DMM. If I choose that, I get the multimeter type of view, which just means that all 16 channels display their digital value at the current moment. It's easy to read from across the room, or if you're walking by writing temperatures down in a notebook or something like that. But if I want to see the waveforms, I can choose one of the other display groups. I'll just grab one of the thermocouples with my finger so that we have some change in the temperature. And we'll see that temperature go up. And then I'll let go so the temperature will start decreasing. Along the top of the screen, we see a gray progress bar slowly moving to the left. That's our progress from zero data all the way up to 2 minutes of data. And on the top right, you see a blue rectangle. That's showing you which piece of data is visible in the main screen. So during recording, I can click that blue square and I can drag it backwards into the past to see what has happened since I started the recording. Or I can leave it all the way at the right just to see the most recent data updates. I hope this video demonstrated to you how easy it is to do long-term data recording with the DL350 ScopeCorder. For more information, please look for links in the description and click subscribe to follow us on our YouTube channel.